for us, Jake. The flame is our hearts. How dare you? Get out!
Please, just hear what I have to say.
No. I want you to leave.
You marry Jake and you're gonna regret it, Gillian.
You can't get past your own regrets, can you, Ryan? Have you suddenly realized something about us? Why now? Because I have someone else in my life? I bet if I didn't have Jake in my life, you wouldn't even be here.
I know why you're rushing into this marriage,
Gillian. No, you don't know anything!
Jake is not Colby's father.
Oh, Ryan, that is absurd. Is this what you've come to?
I know that Adam is her real father, Gillian. I know that. And I see you're on a mission, desperate to help Jake win the custody battle for Colby. I see that, and I understand that that decision is coming from the best possible place, from love, from compassion. But you're making a mistake, Gillian.
Don't you dare tell me what my mistakes are. Okay, Ryan? And don't presume that you still have a place in my heart like you think you do. You can't possibly know what I'm thinking.
Can I admire your courage? The night of the accident, you were going to see Jake. You wanted to tell him then.
Because he deserved to hear the news from somebody who cared about him.
What changed?
It doesn't matter, Ryan. Jake deserve what Adam did to him. He's a beautiful, sweet man, and I will do anything to make him happy.
What is this marriage going to be built on, Gillian? You're lying to him. You must be torn up inside with this secret.
I love him, okay? And that's enough.
Then why don't you tell him?
Because he's the best father for Colby.
That is not your decision to make, Gillian.
That is exactly what Liza wanted in the first place.
But that's when he was willing to share the custody of the child. You still have time to tell him the truth, Gillian. Somebody has got to tell him.
Don't you dare think that he's going to be you. Please, don't tell this to Jake. Please, just leave Colby out of this.
The only person I'm interested in is you, Gillian. Who gets Colby is none of my business, and it shouldn't be yours either.
I've made it mine.
Yes, you have. And when Jake finds out, and believe me, he's gonna find out, you're gonna lose everything that you're fighting for right now. He's gonna lose Colby, and I'm sorry to say this, but he is gonna hate you.
Don't say that.
You've suffered enough pain for a lifetime, Gillian. Most of which is caused by me, and I will not stand by and watch you get hurt again.
Jake loves me. And other than Colby, I'm the most important thing in his life.
Then why don't you put that to the test? Tell him. If you two really have something, if you really have something, and I mean this, then trust it. We never did, Gillian. Our marriage was so full of lies that no wonder it didn't work out. Why even settle for one lie when you're gonna spend a lifetime with somebody? Let me take you back to Jake. Maybe it'll work out, and maybe it won't. But you have to be honest to find that out.
I'm going to marry Jake. I've made my choice, and we're going to fight for Colby.
Would you listen to yourself, please?
Ryan, please don't try and convince me otherwise. I've made up my mind. Go to Green Sleeves. Whatever, twist her life around.
What are you talking about?
Green leaf, green tea, whatever.
I'm not seeing her.
Maybe not tonight.
Believe me, Gillian, that's over.
Believe you, Ryan? You are the best liar I've ever met in my life. Now I want you to get out of my room. Get out before I scream. I swear I will.
I would be willing to lose you, Gillian, if I was convinced that what you felt for each other was strong, was beautiful, was honest. But whatever you say you feel for him cannot possibly compare to my love for you. Yes. Yes, Gillian, I love you. From the deepest part of me, I love you, and I know you love me too. And I will not be that guy who stands back and dreams about his past when he's got this incredible future ahead of him, this beautiful future. It's you, Gillian. It's always been you, and I'm ready now. I can handle it, and let me tell you something. There's nobody else out there that can love you the way I can. And I want to start. I want to start right now. Always loved you, Gillian. You gotta believe me, princess, please. It's taking me a long time to realize it. It has, but living without you, it's made me realize how much I really do love you. I've never stopped. I don't want to. Don't marry Jake, please. Don't marry Jake. Let me be the one to love you the way you deserve to be loved, with passion, with fire, from my soul, from my body, Gillian. Gillian, baby, every word I'm saying to you is the truth. I love you.
Oh. Get out!
Don't do it. Don't mistake misguided duty for love, Gillian.
I am marrying Jake, and nothing you can say will change that.
But you don't love him.
I do. Any woman would be lucky to be his wife.
But you are not any woman, Gillian.
Ryan, I am gonna do this. This is the right thing.
You want to help a man who helped you. You got hurt, so you want to play it safe. Those are not reasons to get married. Gillian, do not deny your real feelings.
You stopped me when I wanted to marry Scott because you claimed you loved me. And now you want to stop me from marrying Jake because you love me? It was a lie, Ryan, then, and it's a lie now.
I have never been more honest about anything in my whole life, Gillian. I swear to you, you go through with this wedding and you're the one who's going to be living a lie.
Stop it.
I can't stop it. I can't stop it because I can't stop what I feel, and you know what? Either can you. Whether you believe me or you don't, whether you love me or you don't, I'm telling you this. I have never loved anybody else.
Ryan told me that he loved me, that I was the only woman that could ever make him feel that way.
You gotta believe me, princess.
No, no, this is a trick.
No, no, this is real.
You say you love me in the moonlight, and then when the sun comes up, who knows what you're gonna feel, Ryan? You say you know me, but I know you. I know. I've learned to believe that everything you say, I can trust that.
That was the past, Gillian. Please believe me. That was the past. This is now. And the future. Our future.
Gillian? You all right?
Evan, please, just get him out of here.
Brian, I don't know what's going on here, but your timing stinks.
Gillian's making a big mistake, Edmund.
No, he's completely lost his mind. I've asked him to leave. He won't.
Okay, let's go.
This is so wrong.
Ryan. I've always been so fond of you. Please don't change that. Please do what Gillian asks.
Eugenia, you don't
Come
understand.
Come on, let's see. We'll just straighten this out later, okay?
No, this has got to be settled right now.
Edmund, please, just get him out of here.
She doesn't know what she wants.
That's not for you to say.
She's making a mistake if she marries Jake, believe me. And she knows why,
Edmund,
because this is a lie.
Don't talk to me like I'm not here. Edmund, please, just don't listen to him. Make him go away.
Right, let's go. Come on.
Fine. I'm going. I will leave as soon as you tell me that you're not marrying Jake.
I am marrying Jake.
You can't marry Jake. Edmund, please, make her understand she can't marry him. Not when she loves me. This is your last chance, Gillian. Your last chance to do what's right.
That's exactly what I'm doing, Ryan. For once, I'm doing the right thing. Edmund, please.
I'm sorry, Ryan.
What has Ryan been telling you?
You heard him. He says it's a mistake to marry Jake.
Well, darling, he'll always have a feeling for you. I mean, now that you're marrying another man, I suppose he realizes what he's lost.
It's not all, Grandmama. He knows that Jake is not Colby's father.
Oh, dear, that's not good. But it's not really his concern.
Is he right, Grandmama? Am I making a mistake to marry Jake, keeping this secret from him?
You are following your heart, aren't you?
Ryan told me that he loves me.
Do you love him?
It's all lies. And he wants to stop me from marrying Jake, and he wants to sleep with another woman.
Another woman? You mean Greenlee?
Oh, he just confuses me so much.
Well, the only way to unspark confusion is to confront it face to face. Did you tell Ryan that you knew about him and Greenlee?
No, wouldn't have gotten a real answer anyway. He just twists the truth around. It would have just confused me more. I'm getting married tomorrow. This is supposed to be the happiest day of my life. Am I doing what's best?
Sweetheart, only you can answer that.
How?
Oh, I don't know, by looking into yourself. What do you see?
A man who fills every part of me. And a child who needs the best father.
Well, then there's your answer. You're going to marry Jake and have a wonderful life with your husband and your child. You don't think that Ryan would ever tell Jake that Colby isn't his child?
No, he said he wouldn't.
Yes, but he's been so relentless in trying to stop this marriage. Are you sure he would? Are you worried about Ryan?
I just hope that he won't tell Jake that he's not Colby's real father.
Well, you know Ryan very well. He has disappointed you in the past, it's true.
Well, he swears that he changed.
Do you believe him?
Is he gone?
Yeah, I escorted him off the property. Security.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Well, I don't know about you, but it's late and I need my beauty sleep before the festivities.
Good night, Grandmama.
Good night, my love. Same goes for you. I mean, we can't have a bride with great black smudges under her eyes.
I'll go right to bed, I promise.
Night, sweetheart.
Good night.
Ah, but will you sleep?
Probably not.
Good night. You know, you don't have to go through with this wedding tomorrow if you don't want to.
I want to. I'm gonna marry Jake.
What did Ryan mean when he said that your marriage would be based on a lie?
It's all in his head.
You sure? Gillian, I love you, and all I care about is your happiness. So if for any reason you've had a change of heart, and you want to postpone the wedding, or you want to cancel it, you do that, okay? And I will support you no matter what. No matter what you chose.
I chose Jake. And I want to go through with this very much.
I saw the way that he looked at you. The way you looked at Ryan.
A lot of memories there. And I'm really tired.
Tequila, please. Double shot.
Uh-oh. Ryan looks terrible.
Yeah? How terrible?
About a double shot's worth of misery.
Well, it looks like he needs a friend. Why don't you go talk to him?
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'll go buy the groom a drink.
You know, that glass is not nearly big enough for you to drown yourself in.
Hey.
How'd it go with Gillian?
Not so good. I told her I loved her. And, that she couldn't marry Jake, not until she knows what she wants.
She didn't take it too well?
No, she didn't.
She didn't appreciate you ambushing her on her wedding night to proclaim your undying love.
You think I'm being arrogant, I understand. Believe me, Haley, I know I'm the cause for all of this.
What did she say?
You know what? I just pushed her closer to Jake. She's got all these reasons. Reasons for marrying him.
Well, obviously she feels that her reasons are solid.
Yeah. Yeah, well, I'm just hoping she wakes up and she realizes that I'm right, and she calls off this wedding. Or at least she delays it a little while.
Ryan, maybe she really loves Jake.
She loves me as much as I love her. She does.
Well, learning to trust again is not always easy.
So, you know, so what does she do? She opts for safety? Haley, you know, that's not an answer.
Come on, Ryan, listen to yourself. She made a choice. You have to respect it.
Well, I can't respect it. I can't.
Oh, Ryan, you have to. Listen to me. Jake loves Gillian. He loves her. Gillian has made him come to life. I mean, look at him. Look, turn around. Doesn't that speak for itself?
I'm the real one. No, it really doesn't, actually.
Ryan, come on.
Haley, you didn't see her, okay? You don't understand.
I'll be right back.
Hello.
Can I talk to you for a second?
You mind?
Haley, will you...
No, I'm going to go check on the guy.
Thanks.
Okay. All right.
All right.
I know how you feel about Gillian. But don't worry. I'll take care of her. I'll always be there for her. She's gonna know that she's always loved every day for the rest of her life. That's really it.
We can only turn.
I love you. I'll always.